What's going on? Welcome back to the channel. As you can see from the title of the video today, I'm going to be reacting to Tool. The track is called Prison Sex. It's the second track off of the Undertow album. And I am not much of a gambling man, but if I was to make a bet, I'm going to say that this track probably isn't directly related to having sex in a prison. But who knows? It's probably some like underlying meaning to like a really well thought out, structured rhyming scheme that Maynard has thought up with when he was fucking high on shrooms one day when he was like 19. But who knows, guys, we're gonna jump straight into this one. And before we do, we're also gonna be doing a music video, or like a video. I think this was made by Adam Jones, who apparently has like some digital graphic designing degree or some shit, I don't know. The only other video I've done by Tool is Schism, and that was the weirdest thing I've ever seen. So I'm kind of looking forward to this. I can see the thumbnail and it looks like it's going to be going with that weird like fucking like Play-Doh man vibe. So we're going to jump into this one, guys. Drop the video a like if you haven't already. Sub to the channel if you are new. And to get early access to all these videos, the Patreon link will be in the description if you want to join the community that we have over there. Also, if you want to sponsor one of these videos, please do hit me up at the email on screen and in the description as well. And that's providing I remember to edit this correctly. And if not, it will be in the description regardless. If you want to put like a 30-second clip of one of your bands, or if you're a solo artist and you have some music that you want to share to maybe like tens of thousands of people, then do hit me up and we can organize something for you. Okay, now let's fuck it up. Without any further ado, guys, let's jump into it. Let's go. I've got no lyrics for this one, by the way. That thing is. That video is such a distraction. I can see why. This is generally why I tend to stray away from like doing the official Tool music videos, because they're too weird and they like demand your attention. So you just find yourself like trying to figure out what's actually going on when it's not really relative to anything, like the story. It doesn't actually mean anything in terms of the lyrics. It's just like random shit. So I'm gonna watch it, but not like intentively watch it. I'm gonna try and pay attention to this more so than anything, okay? What has been done to me?
Mine.
what am I actually watching right now? They always do weird shit with fingers. I don't like that stuff. It's so hard to not pay attention to, that's the problem. You see, it's this kind of shit that's like a bit hard to explain to people who are outside of the genre, or, well, I suppose Tool nearly can go into their own genre, but it's this kind of shit that's hard to explain. You're like, oh, I've got this really amazing band I need to show you. Like, for example, my dad has become like interested in Tool purely because he's subscribed to me on YouTube or whatever. I wouldn't say he's like an avid YouTube watcher, but he does occasionally, well, I didn't know that he did this, but he was just like, oh, yeah, I've been watching some of your videos recently. And I was like, oh shit, well, that's a bit weird. But then he was like, he started saying like, oh, I haven't listened to that band that you've been covering Tool. And he really liked the idea of me like going through their whole discography as opposed to just jumping from band to band. And he was like really into the band as well. He was like, no, they've got some really good tracks. And then one day I actually posted it on my Patreon, which you can obviously go and join up there if you want. It's just a kind of better insight into what I do on a day-to-day basis, maybe around YouTube, or you'll just get an idea of what videos I'm planning going forward. But, and I mean, you don't have to join up obviously, but this is just an idea. And I'm referring to this moment where I came downstairs one day because I heard, I didn't know what track it was at the time, but I knew it was a Tool track because obviously it's got such a distinct sound. But it was Push It, because I heard it playing on a speaker downstairs, and I was like, I wasn't playing music on the speaker. And then I came down and it was like, I walked in on my dad and it was just on his phone, like he had it on Spotify. So he had actually gone himself. So from watching my videos, he had gone, and which is cool because obviously you'd almost expect him to have passed it on to me, because Tool being such an older band and like going like what, 30, 35 years, like me only being 22, my dad obviously being in his 50s, you would think that he would kind of instill the enjoyment of that kind of music into me, whereas it's almost like the opposite way around, which is really cool. But my point being is that like, you kind of like, this seems normal to me, and like that video in a sense, it, like I probably should have avoided the video, but a lot of people did say to check it out because it's kind of funny in a way, but you can see why the video can take away, and I can feel it myself because I'm not paying too much attention to the lyrics or even listening to the song. So obviously in my own time I will go back and listen to the track again. I've just been banging out their albums in my car going to work back and forth. But for like, if you're to show a video like this, or if someone knows you listen to Tool and they're like, right, let's just throw on a Tool track and see what it's all about, and they look at like a video like this, it doesn't make sense to someone who's outside it, but it makes so much sense to someone who just has experience and listen to their music and knows what the band, especially Maynard, that kind of weird, well, I suppose this is all Adam Jones, I think, as far as I'm aware, he does all that kind of like graphic design-y shit. But yeah, like I will have to listen to the track again, so I don't really have much review per se. It's more just a reaction to the video and the track itself. It did seem alright, like it wasn't one of my favourite Tool tracks. There was no real moments where it really jumped out to me, but then again, I was paying a lot of attention to the video despite trying not to. But like I said, throughout. It just kind of demands your attention when there's like a fucking alien that you can take his eyes out and he's like a robot, but then he turns into a caterpillar. I mean, there's just so much going on. You're kind of like trying to figure out what the plot is, but then in classic Tool fashion, like, there is no point after all that. Like, what happened? I don't know. But yeah, guys, I'm gonna wrap the video up there. I'm actually just gonna check out some of the lyrics. I won't do it on camera. I'm just gonna figure out what it was for myself. Obviously, it has a kind of a cool name. Not even sure, because the lyrics are quite hard to actually pick up on when you don't have them on screen. I don't even know if it actually related to sex in prison. It probably had some weird metaphor related to it, like they usually do. But that's going to be it for this, guys. If you did enjoy, please do drop a like if you're excited for more of the Undertow album. I'm nearly certain that might be Sober next, which again is obviously a huge request. And then we have the live version to get to as well. So if you are looking forward to that one, please do drop a like. Sub to the channel if you are new, guys. If you want to join on Patreon as well, you know the links will be in the description. You'll get early access to the Sober reactions, as well as most of my other reactions that I'm going to be doing going forward. And you'll also be joining the community and helping the channel to grow, as well as supporting me as a creator. And if you want to sponsor any videos, then the link will be in the description. The email will be in the description if you want to jump on a sponsor and get your band out there, get some of your music out there, whatever it may be. Yeah, guys, I'm shutting up now. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Take it easy. Cheers.